called the UK Summit. I have questions on Tawhid. Yeah. I am asking the question, while Muslims make a claim that they worship one God, he's identified as Allah alone, I am curious, why do Muslims also worship man called Muhammad during their prayer? Because Muslims pray five times a day. After the second rakah, after the sajda, you talk to Muhammad directly. Muhammad has been dead since 632. It's been 1,400 years. He's dead. His bodies are being eaten probably by animals. But when you pray, prayer is the part of your worship. You directly talk to that person. Why do you do that? Why do you commit shirk, Yahya?
You done?
Yeah, do you want to keep the timing? Shall we
I'm done.
Work with timing. I'm done.
You're done already?
Yeah. So I just answer what?
Yeah, answer.
Okay.
Means man in Greek.
Sorry.
Please attend your My name is Yahya. Sayyid F11, comment. And the question was, why we worship Muhammad, the dead prophet, peace upon him. And the subject actually is about Tawheed, which everybody knows that Allah, you will find in your Bible in Genesis 1:31, the word Allah mentioned 31 times. And we worship Allah, whom Jesus, peace upon him, submit, serve, obey, glorify, serve, and fell on his face to worship him. To worship him only. Regarding the prophet, peace upon him, we always, when we talk about any prophet, we say peace be upon them as matter of respect and glorifying those prophets. And Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, we don't worship him, but he conveys the message of the oneness of God, which we will find in the Bible.
So, do you believe, Yahya, prayer is the part of worship?
The prayer is the worship.
Okay, prayer is the worship. Just a moment. I just want to clarify. So, prayer is the part of worship. Prayer is the worship, sorry. And when you do your five prayers a day, you worship Allah. Correct? Correct. So, do you say this phrase in your prayer, Yahya? Peace and mercy of Allah be upon you, O Muhammad. Do you say this after the sajda?
After the sajda, we send salutation upon the Prophet and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send his blessing, love, mercy, forgiveness upon the Prophet and Prophet as well, peace upon him, Ibrahim.
What do you say when it comes to Muhammad?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. The prayer be upon the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam and his descendant and his family and all his followers, and as well on Prophet Ibrahim and all his descendants.
So I'm going to ask my question once again, and this is very clear question, okay? Do you say in your prayer, okay, peace be upon you, O Prophet, and the mercy of Allah and his blessing? Do you say this phrase? In Arabic, it's alayka ayula nabuya.
Yeah.
Do you say that?
We address the Prophet with our salutation, and the Prophet, as he informed us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him his spirit to reply as salam to anyone who send salam for him. So it's not as you are
Sorry,
saying.
Sorry, repeat that part again?
It's not as you are saying.
Before that, can
the
you
Prophet,
repeat the part again?
Alayhi salatu wasalam, inform us that the earth, it's forbidden for us to eat the body of the Prophet and Messenger. And they are conserved till the day of a judgment. So they are not dismantle as anybody else. And when...
you are not answering my question. My question is, while you do your 5 times prayer a day, which is the 17th rakat, after the 2nd rakat, do you talk to Muhammad by saying, peace be upon you, O Muhammad? That's yes or no question. Do you do that?
My answer is yes.
Okay, so if you do that as a yes, let me just need to clarify that, okay? So you say that to Muhammad, and you already told me prayer is worship. And in your prayer, you talk to Muhammad. So then my question steps in. Why do you worship Muhammad? How many times a day you worship Muhammad? Isn't that a shirk? Doesn't it make you the concern for your eternity? Why do you give the sifats of Allah to mankind?
Okay. I would like you, one, not to interrupt. Second, listen, because I'm answering you. Then you come back with the same question. It seems that you are asking the question, but you are never listening to the answer. Again, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we go directly by addressing the Prophet with salutation, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us to do. And the worshiping of Allah, it's unique, worshiping to the mighty God. But Prophet Muhammad, as a due of respect and love and appreciation for to convey the message for us as a Muslim, because he is the cause of all of us that to become Muslim, because he convey and confirm the prophethood of Jesus, who said the Lord our God is one. So he confirmed the message which being conveyed by all the prophet and messenger, the Lord our God is one God, Allah, and we don't worship any prophet, messenger, or stone, or any saint.
Okay,
our worship is for the creator of the creator.
Everything, yeah, okay. So let me just respond. First of all, thank you so much for confirming, yes, you do worship Muhammad, because you said, yes, we directly address the prophet. In your worship, if you are directly addressing the prophet, that means you are worshipping the prophet. Muhammad is dead, and you are directly addressing a man who has been dead for 1,400 years. How can that man hear your prayer? Why do you give the attributes of Allah, the sifats of Allah, to that person? Why do you commit shirk, and how many times a day do you commit shirk?
Okay. Again, the Prophet, peace upon him, inform us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, forbid earth to eat the flesh of any prophet. And I already said, because...
I'm not talking about your dinner time. I'm asking a simple question. Why do you commit shirk by worshipping, doing ibadah to Muhammad? You already confirmed that. Give me the reason.
Please don't interrupt. Please, I didn't interrupt
but
you.
But I'm not talking about your dinner time. Just answer my question.
Have some self-respect.
I am having pretty much respect, actually.
And when I talk, you zip it. And you listen, please.
That's a very respectful statement from you. Thank you.
Because you're showing no respect. Now I'm not going to show you any respect. I said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid the earth to eat the flesh of the prophet. And I said the prophet informed us that when we send a blessing and salutation about the prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him his spirit to reply to us. Are you registering what I'm saying? Or I have to say it again 300 times till you get it. We don't worship Prophet Muhammad. We send him salutation. And this is commanded by Almighty God to send salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad and upon Ibrahim and his descendants.
Let me respond to that. First of all, as I stated, I am not here to find out what you are going to have in your dinner, that you are not going to eat the flesh of your prophet. I am not here for your dinner time conversation. You already confirmed to me that you directly address Muhammad in your prayer. You already told me prayer is the worship. Therefore, I am asking the question, why do you worship a dead man? It's not only he's dead, he's been double dead for 1,400 years. That's the first question. Second, you made a response and then you told me that actually this is what Allah wants. Allah wants you to directly to speak to a dead person. No, Allah doesn't want that because it comes from your prophet. I am sure you know your Islamic tradition better than me, but let me read it some of the traditions to you.
Can I answer before you carry on?
No, I'm going to read the tradition to you.
I don't need the tradition because I follow Quran. And the tradition...
Oh, you are Quran only now? Are you Quran only Muslim now?
No. Anything, it's not a tradition. If you are now coming to hadith, there's a lot of hadith are fake, fabricated, and false, and weak. And you, as usual, you pick up the fake hadith which offends the prophet, and you come up with. So let me cut it short for you. First, you accuse me of eating the flesh of Prophet Muhammad, but Jesus teach you, this is my body, eat it, and this is the wine, this is my drink, eat it. You are the one who's zombie, and you are the one who's a Dracula. Not the Muslim. And I told you, we don't worship Muhammad. And this is for maybe the fifth time I say it. We worship God who sent Muhammad as your main God, Jesus. Worship our God, Allah, which you deny. Up to you.
Okay, let me respond. First of all, I'll start with the last point. I am very disappointed that you've been to Speaker's Corner enough. You've been engaging with Christians enough and you still didn't understand what Christians believe about Jesus. Jesus is not man-God, Jesus is God-man. Word of God took up human flesh, came and dwelt among us and gave his life for mankind. We have wine and bread joining the communion in the church to remember the sacrificial love Jesus has for us. When he died on the cross, he gave up his life so that people like you, people like me can have eternal life with God. That is what we do. And you should be grateful for that. And you should be repenting and worshiping the one who gave his life on the cross for you. But
you're done?
No, I haven't done yet. But maybe it will be a good opportunity. This is the time you just confront your brother for making fun of his eternity. My question was very simple. You already told me that prayer is worship. You already told me that you address directly your Prophet Muhammad. Okay? Listen to the question carefully. That is shirk. Does Muhammad capable to hear your prayer as you address him? Do you believe Muhammad can hear your prayer?
Yes.
So Muhammad can hear your prayer.
And he will reply as well.
Okay, Muhammad hears your prayer and then Muhammad can reply your prayer. Am I right to put together that Muhammad is your new God alongside of Allah? Allah is the one who should be able to answer the question, why Allah is using middleman, a sinful middleman who has been dead for 1,400 years to hear your prayer and answer your prayer. For Muhammad to hear your prayer, for Muhammad to answer your prayer, Muhammad must have the sifats of Allah. Muhammad must have the attributes of Allah. He must be knowing, all knowing, who are those Muslims who are praying to Muhammad. Muhammad must be all powerful to being able, capable to answer all of their prayer. It's not only shirk, it is double and double shirk, Yahya. You've got to repent. Shirk is gonna take you to hell, and hell is very, very bad place in Islam, Yahya. So thanks for confirming that your Allah and your Prophet allows you to commit shirk. But this is the opportunity for you. If you don't want to commit shirk, you've got to give up. This is the opportunity for you because you heard it now. You've got to respond. What you do? You give up Islam. You give up Muhammad. You give up Quran. And you come and worship the only true God, Lord Jesus Christ, Yahya.
Are you ready to listen? Okay, allow me to answer, please. Can you please?
Goes back to one religion.
Would you please allow me to answer? Would you please?
All the way of life.
Would you please kindly?
It was copied by Judaism and Islam.
You're not listening. You're not listening.
You said. This is your last statement.
You said. You said Jesus gave his life. So why, as long as he gave his life, he contradicted himself and going and asking his father to take away the cup of death of him as long as he's willing to die for ourselves? This is one. I'm not asking you. I'm answering her. And she said, God who died. So your God, he couldn't find any solution to forgive the sinner, his creation, even when they repent to forgive them, but to kill himself. And then, and you're making the God the Father, you have two problems. We have God the Father is God, and God the Son is God. So we end up with two God contradicting the teaching of Jesus, who teach the Lord our God is one God. So we have two God here. And as the Bible teach that Jesus will be seated at the right hand side of the mighty God, the true God. And John 17:3, Jesus teaching us, teaching you, who is the true God. That they may know that you, the true God, and whom Jesus came, whom you have sent. So he's a messenger sent only to the lost sheep of Israel, and to confirm that Jesus teach his apostle not to go to Gentile and Samaritan, rather go to lost sheep of Israel, and he will judge them. And in Matthew, you will find all the reference about what I'm talking about. Any Christian know exactly what I'm saying. And you, how you are blaming me for shirk, and you are the one who are worshiping a man being sent by God to the lost sheep of Israel. Besides, your Bible degraded Jesus as a racist and a liar. And lot of things Jesus said didn't come to be true. And Jesus, from what he said when he talked to the Canaanian woman, he loved the Jew and he calls them children, while the non-Jew, he referred to them as dogs. So me and you, we are dogs in the eye of Jesus, which is the one you worship.
Yeah. Let me respond.
And the worship, according to Jesus, is to fall on his face and worship Almighty God. You don't worship God, you praise Jesus, but you don't worship him. And you don't know the difference between praising God or worshiping God. And shame on you and your God, who incarnate from God, immortal, to become mortal. He is the dumb Dracula God who wants a price of blood to forgive. God doesn't love you. He loves blood.
Let me respond.
Please respond.
First of all, that was your conclusion. And it seems that as you spend time in Spain, you forgot all your debate skills. And in your conclusion statement, you just made lots of false claims and new claims, which is not acceptable in the debate circles. So I just want everyone to listen that very carefully.
Please. Let her destroy her Christianity by answering. Answer.
Listen that very carefully.
I'm listening very, very carefully.
I am Christian. My scripture teaches, I worship in one God.
Which one? The Father or the Son?
No, any form or shape. There is only one God.
Which God
and
you
that
worship?
God is
the
identified.
Father.
Yeah, yeah, shush, it's my time.
No.
That was your conclusion. You finished your conclusion. So,
you wait.
Which God you worship?
We want to know which God.
And that God is identified as God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. Three persons in one being. That's all it is.
So here is the problem.
I am simply questioning. While Muslims claim to worship only Allah and Allah alone, and as Yahya confirmed, Muhammad is the one who hears the prayer of Muslims. And as Yahya confirmed, Dawatim confirms that Muhammad is capable to answer their prayer. My question to the Muslims. My question to the Muslims.
To me.
If Muhammad is capable to hear your prayers, if Muhammad is capable to answer your prayers, if Muhammad is capable
to go through your wishlist, salutation upon Muhammad, the prayer is to ward God. My conclusion, I allowed you to speak. You are twisting the word and you are a liar and a deceiver. With my great respect, you're a liar and a deceiver.
So we that was Yahya's conclusion.
Yeah.
Yahya already confirmed.
Let her speak, yeah.
Muhammad hears their prayer. How long has been Muhammad dead? 1,400 years. Yahya already confirmed. Muhammad answers their prayer.
He answers the salutation.
Muhammad is dead.
Answers the salutation.
How can Muhammad answer the salutation. Their prayer?
Hello?
Since when that man can answer the prayer of people? If Muhammad is capable to do that, Allah gives his attributes to Muhammad. Allah commits shirk. Muhammad commits shirk, and Muslims today commit shirk by knowing that they directly pray to Muhammad. They directly speak to Muhammad. That is shirk, and that shirk is gonna take you to hell. Only way you can get away from this is you give up Islam, you give up Muhammad, you give up Quran, and come and worship Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That's all it is. Give up Islam, repent, and worship Lord Jesus Christ.